Hello and good day. Welcome to the National Center for Teacher Education, the Philippine Normal University. We welcome you to this series of presentation about the philosophical foundation of education. Today, we are going to present to you Essentialism. Our objectives are the following. 1. We are going to enumerate the different tenets of Essentialism. 2. We are going to find out how this philosophy affects the educative process, specifically the teaching-learning process. And 3, we are going to find out how this philosophy is utilized in the Philippine educational setting. So I hope you will enjoy this presentation, and at the end of this, you will be willing to do the different activities prepared for you so that you will have a firm grasp of Essentialism and its influence to Philippine education. Again, good day and enjoy. Essentialism. Essentialism is a theory that asserts that education properly involves the learning of the basic skills, arts, and sciences that have been useful in the past and are likely to remain useful in the future. It focuses on intellectual discipline. It is the educational theory that sees the primary function of the school to be the preservation and transmission of the basic elements of human culture. It opposes catering to childish whims or transitory fads that will cause schools to degenerate into mindless and irrelevant institutions. The curriculum consists of core skills like reading, writing, and arithmetic, teaching essential facts and concepts on science, literature, health, and PE, teaching hard sciences, technical and vocational courses, teaching arts for aesthetic expression, and teaching values of discipline, hard work, and perfect authority. It is not to take on non-essential functions such as social adjustment, career education, consumer education, cooking classes, and the like. Its primary mission is academic. It opposes using the school as experimental laboratories to test curricula on institutional innovation. It has a well-defined curricular orientation, which asserts that the curriculum should provide students with a differentiated and organized learning experience rather than with an undifferentiated experience that students must organize themselves. The teacher is an academic authority figure. The method of teaching makes use of deductive method, recitation, assignments, analysis and synthesis, and race and social heritage over experience. The role of the teacher is to provide stimulating activities for learning, to prepare well-organized lessons to prove he is an authority of instruction, and the teacher is authoritative and disciplinarian. After viewing the presentation, it is hoped that you were able to undergo the different activities prepared for you in order to have a firm grasp of the role of the philosophy of education in the teaching learning process. I do hope that you appreciate the role of philosophy in the educative process. Thank you for being with us. Have a nice day.